YouTube, Edgar here, and welcome to Artifexian. Here you will learn everything you ever wanted to know about world building and then some. Last time we looked at the life cycle of low-mass sun-like stars, but there are many different types of stars in our universe. Okay, let's now look at the life cycle of a star very different to our own sun, one with much less mass than our own sun, say around 10%. These type of objects are called brown dwarfs. They exist in a kind of grey area between the most massive gas giants and the least massive stars. So in many ways they are like a star, but not really, and also like a planet, but not really. There are three main types of brown dwarf, L, T, and Y dwarfs. They are commonly referred to as substellar objects. Substellar objects tend to be measured in terms of Jupiter masses as opposed to solar masses, which highlight the ambiguous nature of brown dwarfs. Regardless of mass, all stars form much the same way. Gravity will cause the GMC to collapse and form knots of matter in the centre of the cloud. These knots will grow more and more massive as more matter is drawn into them. When the density and temperature is just right, the core of the star will begin nuclear fusion, emit photons, and as a result shine. It is this nuclear fusion that defines what it is to be a star and also stabilizes it, preventing further gravitational collapse. However, due to their lack of mass, brown dwarfs rarely get to the fusion stage, or if they do, it's only for a very brief period of time. So how do they remain stable and not collapse in on themselves? Brown dwarfs are typically 13 to 75 times the mass of Jupiter, but are rarely bigger in size than Jupiter. This means a brown dwarf is a very dense object. So dense that the electrons in the core of the dwarf start to push outwards, trying desperately to stay away from one another, and this outward force perfectly balances the inward force of gravity, hence equilibrium. This process of electrons not wanting to be around other electrons is called free electron degeneracy. However, some brown dwarfs do get a small taste of stardom. The very massive brown dwarfs, say 60 Jupiter masses and up, would briefly enter the main sequence, fusing hydrogen in their cores. But they soon realize that electron degeneracy is more for them and quickly turn off the nuclear fires and leave the main sequence. Very low mass brown dwarfs in the order of 20 Jupiter masses may also decide to try being a star for a while and begin to fuse deuterium in their core. Deuterium is an isotope of hydrogen with an added neutron, sometimes called heavy hydrogen. Tangent alert! Heavy water, or deuterium oxide, is almost identical to regular light water, except it is 10% heavier. The Sudbury Neutrino Observatory used 1,000 tons of heavy water stored over 2 kilometers underground in the mine to build a neutrino detector. If the observatory were to have purchased the heavy water at its current market price, it would have set them back just over half a billion US dollars. Or in other words, the total GDP of Tuvalu, Montserrat, Nauru, Kiribati, and the Marshall Islands combined. Anyways, given that deuterium is very rare, these low-mass brown dwarfs soon run out of fuel, stop being a star, and also leave the main sequence. Hence why brown dwarfs are sometimes referred to as failed or aborted stars. They were star-like, briefly, but spend most of their lives being more planet-like. Due to the fact that they are much cooler than real stars, their light output is predominantly in the infrared, and they have planet-like atmospheres with clouds made of heavy metal oxides. The term brown dwarf is a misnomer. If our sun was replaced by a brown dwarf, it would glow in the blue and red end of the light spectrum, so purple or magenta dwarfs would be a more suitable name. They also tend to form binary pairs less often than real stars, about 20% of the time to be exact. They are often found in orbit around very low mass stars or other brown dwarfs. A scenario whereby a brown dwarf orbits a star of mass equal to or greater than our sun is unlikely, but not impossible. The least massive brown dwarf ever observed is OTS 44. It weighs in at 15 Jupiter masses, or 0.015 times the mass of our sun. Even though OTS 44 has so little mass, evidence of a planet forming disk around it has been found, giving way to the idea that planets may orbit these cosmic dwarfs. Brown dwarfs form like stars. Some briefly experience being a star, but all, in the long run, never maintain nuclear fusion in their cores, so they can't really be classified as stars in their own right. After the nuclear fires have turned off, they linger in space, slowly cooling for billions of years, fading rather than dying explosively. So there you have it, the life cycle of browny, purpley, starry, planety, dwarfy type things. Guys, like and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. Never change, and I will see you next time. Edgar out.